Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers, my sisters, I've just completed the Umrah here in Makkah al-Mukarramah. I had come in from Medina Munawwara and I'm going back to Medina Munawwara. But I intended to make Umrah in Ramadan, and so I decided, let's take the train. MashaAllah, what a beautiful mode of transport. We must thank Allah Almighty for giving us so many different modes of transport. Man was granted the knowledge to come up with all of this. And subhanAllah, in 2.5 hours, I was from Medina all the way in the Haram in Makkah al-Mukarramah. So Alhamdulillah. And what I did is, just before the time of iftar, the time of the opening of the fast, I decided to enter the masjid and start the circumambulation or the tawaf. And thereafter we completed the tawaf, mashallah, tabarakallah. In fact, we completed part of it and it was already time to open the fast, mashallah. The ambience, amazing. I tell you something I learned and I've been reminded of. Everyone has their own needs and each one calls out to Allah, and Allah hears each one uniquely, directly, completely, privately, at the same moment, and Allah responds to a billion people all at once. That is just amazing. It's a gift of Allah Almighty. So Allah Almighty creates a need in the people, then they call out to Him and He hears the call of every single person at the same moment. Do you imagine? I'm calling out to Allah, crying to Him, seeking from Him my issues, my problems, seeking forgiveness, seeking ease in my path, protection, seeking protection from harm, from evil, and so on, asking Allah goodness of this world and the hereafter, seeking for my children, for my family members, seeking for everyone else. And Allah Almighty is listening not just to my dua and responding to it, but every single person out there. And we saw everyone crying with their own needs, each person in tears, asking Allah, whatever their unique problems were, I ask Allah to grant each one of us ease in whatever difficulties we may be facing, and to bless us with the response of our du'as, of our supplications. Remember, if Allah does not give you exactly what you want, the way you want it, you are still blessed because you called out to Allah. He will reward you for it. He will grant you something else in its place. He will elevate your status as a result of your dua and the patience you had to bear because of that dua not being given to you the way you wanted. So it's given to you in an even better way. Now, everyone's calling out. Where are these people from? I promise you, they are from every part of the world, the east and the west, the north and the south. And subhanAllah, wherever else you think of, there are people in Makkah al-Mukarramah, in the Holy Lands, from all of those places, the tall and the short, the fat and the thin, whatever it is, Allah loves all. And Allah listens to all and Allah responds to all. Don't think for a moment that you will not be heard by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's amazing. We had thereafter Salatul Maghrib. Everyone was passing a date to each other. I didn't have a date in my hand. And I looked down and the brother gave me a date. MashaAllah, may Allah reward him. I opened my fast and subhanAllah, I decided to make dua and at the same time make a little recording in order to inspire the people who cannot make it here. Those who cannot afford the trip. And those are the majority of the Muslims on earth cannot afford the trip to Makkah and Medina. It's the privileged few who can afford this trip. So it's important for us to reach out to them, to tell them we're thinking of them. We're praying that Allah makes it easy for them to come sometime, somehow, inshallah, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we had Salatul Maghrib, it commenced. I was in the mataf, meaning in the open courtyard around the Kaaba where the tawaf or the circumambulation happens. And mashallah, I was right at the door of the Kaaba. At that moment, I felt so important. But there are so many, tens of thousands of people all feeling equally important. Subhanallah. Each one believing in that miracle of standing in front of the door of the Kaaba. The door of Allah in a nutshell. You're standing in front of this door. It's a multazam. Between the door and the black stone is a multazam. A place where people used to cling to in order to cry to Allah for their needs. And subhanallah, that is an amazing place. Right outside there is the footprint of the Prophet Abraham, may peace be upon him. When I was done with my Umrah later on, I came back to this section in order to take a video or two. So some people might say, oh, why were you videoing while you were in Tawaf? No, we had completed everything and we came back inside in order to do the videos. May Allah Almighty grant us goodness. I want to show you, my brothers, my sisters, the footprint of the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. Yes, they've preserved it, they've kept it, and there is, it's known as Maqam Ibrahim. There is a small gold structure, a dome-like structure that is there. If you look inside, you will be able to see this footprint. It is reported that that was a stone that was actually going up and down, helping Ibrahim and his son Ismail, may peace be upon them, take the bricks exactly to where they fitted when they were building the Kaaba initially. And at the end, in the end, what happened is, It softened in order to create a footprint. So Ibrahim alayhi salam's footprints are there right up to the end of time. But my brothers and sisters, another point. All of us were in white. The men, all in two pieces of cloth. It was just amazing. It's a mini hajj. It's a minor pilgrimage. It's an umrah. That's what it is. There is a narration of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, wherein he says that a person who fulfills Umrah or the minor pilgrimage during Ramadan will have a reward equivalent to Hajj. It doesn't mean they fulfilled their Hajj, but the reward will be equivalent to having fulfilled a Hajj. Inshallah, we hope that Allah grant that reward to all of us. So those of you who have been fortunate to do that in Ramadan, good news to you. May Allah bless you and accept it from you. Those of you who have not been able to come, may Allah bring you here. May Allah grant you. May Allah grant you cure and goodness. May Allah fulfill your needs. May Allah grant you ease from your difficulties. And may Allah Almighty give you contentment. And ultimately, may Allah grant us all Jannatul Firdaus. And thereafter, we went to the Sa'i. The Sa'i, which is where the Safa and Marwa happens, the running between the two mounts that Hajar, may peace be upon her, ran, the mother of Ismail, the wife of Ibrahim, may peace be upon them all. And we went seven rounds, subhanallah, and thereafter we came back into the Mataf, like I said. And Salat al-Taraweeh commenced, and it was amazing, it was beautiful, the ambience. Millions of people seeking the pleasure of Allah. Everyone wants to get closer to Allah. And guess what? Each one, Allah gets close to them. It's not like Allah can get close to one and not to the other. He gets close to everyone at the same time. It is not one person who can say, Allah is mine alone and not the others. Allah will get close to all of us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we get close to Him, He has promised every single one of us a unique relationship with us. So build that relationship. That's what Ramadan is all about. That's what this boost is all about. To encourage us to build the relationship with Allah. Month of Ramadan, month of forgiveness, month of the Quran, month of fasting, month of charity, month of cleansing, month of improving, month of changing for the better, month of coming out closer to Allah Almighty with a beautiful day of Eid at the end. May Allah grant that to us. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد.